Coming to the SDS class, what exactly you are understanding? We have chance to understand these are the points from SDS class. First point is, what is data? What is data? Data is nothing but, it's what sir? Anything, it is giving some information. It's called as data. And this group of information is called as knowledge. So simply, a group of data is called as information. A group of information is called as knowledge. This data we divided into two types. One is called as transactional data. Second is analytical data. Transactional data means to run our business regularly day to day, we require that one. Analytical data means that is required to analyze your business, to improve your business, to take the decisions. That's how analytical data is going to play the main role. Then we understand transactional data we are trying to store in one database that is called as OLTP. Analytical data we are trying to store in one database that is known as OLAP. Now, the OLTP versus OLAP differences are available. I am going to discuss that one later point of time. Today we are going to try to understand ODA introduction and also ODA installation. These two things we will try to understand. What is the ODA introduction? Second is what sir? ODA installation. These two things are our agenda. Yesterday we also understand three points we understand how it is different from other reporting, other ETL tools. Our ODA, how it is different from other ETL tools we understand. Number one is what sir? The architecture. The architecture is all the tools are following ETL architecture. That means first is extracting, second is transforming, third is loading. But this is following ELT architecture. First is extracting, second is loading, third is transforming. That is what the architecture wise it is different. Second point is we discussed what sir? Declarative design. That means you are defining what you want. That's it. Remaining all things will be automatically generated for you. I want incremental loading. That only you are defining it. I want incremental loading. Remaining code, whatever is required, automatically it is generating for you. That is what called as declarative design. Third one is predefined knowledge modules for heterogeneous databases. That is what the third differentiator. These three things are not available in another ETL tools. Here it is available. And we are people also aware of it. We are going to cover two things. One is ODA 11G as well as ODA 12C. Both the versions are going to cover. Right. Let us go for today introduction about the Oracle Data Integrator. That is the first thing. Second thing is we need to understand installation of the ODA. These are the two things our agenda, how to install the product and what is the introduction. The introduction points are very important to justify why ODA is best. First point, it is a widely used data integration software product. Oracle Data Integrator provides a new declarative design approach to defining data transformations and integration process, resulting in faster and simpler development and maintenance. Here, what is the new declarative design? Actually, already people are aware of it, what you mean by declarative design, right? If you want parallel, I can open that PowerPoint also so that you come to understand what exactly I mean to tell. So yesterday we saw top three reasons why you are going for ODA. Here we have the declarative design. What you want that we are defining it, then automatically it is generating the required code for you. This is called as declarative design. Because of this one, benefits are available, significantly reduces the learning curve. Whatever you need to learn, n number of, let us say if you go for the ETL, normal ETL tool, 100 steps you need to learn it. Here what sir? Only learn the 10 steps. Remaining 90 steps will be automatically generated in the back end. Next, shorter implementation times. That is obviously right. 100 steps are manually I am creating. It is going to take 100 minutes. Only 10 steps only I need 2 minutes what sir? Only 10 minutes only it is going to take it. Streamline access to non-IT professionals. Even you done, let us say, 2 years or 3 years, you worked as a business analyst guy. You came here and you're trying to understand the ODA also, you're going to understand it. Very easy to understand it. These are the three benefits what are available because of this declarative design. Same points I given here. Because of this declarative design, it is what, sir? Faster, simpler development and maintenance. Faster and simpler development and maintenance. Second point, based on a unique architecture that is called as ELT architecture. It is a unique architecture. In the world of ETL tools, only one tool is available in the market, that is ELT is only ODA, nothing else. Now, because of this one, what is going to happen? Oracle Data Integrator not only guarantees the highest level of performance possible for the execution of data transformation and validation process, but is also the most cost effective solution available today. Three points you want to tell because of this ETL benefits. Number one point is, it is what, sir? Performance is good. Number two point is, best validation it is going to do it. Number three point is, most cost effective solution. The license cost or anything you take it, everything is very less for the ODA comparatively other tools. These are the three solid reasons why ELT is very famous. Next one, Oracle Data Integrator provides a unified infrastructure to streamline data and application integration projects. So they taken best out of it. That's what we have here. All the knowledge modules. These all knowledge modules are what, sir? If you want to load the data or whatever you want to do, we are implemented this one using DW existing best practices. We saw so many projects from last 20 years. From that we taken best practices and we're trying to incorporate here as a knowledge module. Okay. That's what we are saying as it is a unified infrastructure. Because of this unified infrastructure, benefits is, I am working for a customer called as ABC. Tomorrow I need to work for customer called as XYZ. There is nothing to learn much. Because here also what, sir? Unified infrastructure, right? So same plugins will be available, whatever they're here, there also same plugins will be there. But same functionality, let us say one concept I will take that is called as incremental loading, sir. Incremental loading I am doing for ABC client, I am developing it. Same incremental loading you are doing for XYZ customer. In case of ODA, I am enabling one checkbox, you are also enabling the same checkbox. Both are doing same process. But if you take another ETL tool, let us say Informatica or DataStage or Avinitio, I will write my own logic to get the incremental update. You will write your own logic to get the incremental update. Because of this one, what will happen is there is no unified infrastructure. If I change my project, one project to another project, if I change, to understand what you written the code, that will take some time to me. Whenever you resign the job, someone is came and sitting in our project to maintain our project. To understand the existing code is what, sir? It is going to take longer time. But here, it is not going to take longer time. Why? Because the code is, everything is what, sir? Same. Only matter of checkboxes only, right? That is the difference. That's what we are saying as it is a unified infrastructure to streamline data and application integration projects. Next, what is the business problem nowadays we are facing it? What is the business problem nowadays we are facing it? Right, as of now, you people understand, before going for the business problem, Oracle Data Integrator introduction is, it's what, sir? First one is declarative design. Second is ELT architecture. Third is unified infrastructure. If anyone is asked the question, can you give some points about why ODA? Why ODA means I can say these three points. Right. Let us go for the business problem. What business is facing problem? In today's increasingly fast-paced business environment, organizations need to use more specialized software applications. They also need to ensure the coexistence of these applications on heterogeneous hardware platforms and system and guarantee the ability to share data between applications and systems. Applications and systems. What is the meaning of this one? What is the meaning of this one? What is the meaning of this one? I have one thing even that is available in the Google also. If you search that, you are going to get it. Let us say I am going to the Google. Let us say you write here ODI, Oracle Data Integrator PPT. Just write like this. Then we are going to get one slide that is from, this guy is available, right? Take this guy. Let us say right click and open link in new tab. Okay, open with, okay. Then okay, see, this is not prepared by me. In front of you only, I taken from the Oracle guy. He published this one to explain what is ODI. Okay, if you go and see here, this guy is the author who written this slide. And there we have the four key differentiators, whatever I explained yesterday, those things only, these things only is doing. What exactly we have now? We have what, sir? Some legacy systems are available. It may be mainframes, applications or something. Some ERPs are available. That means from some employees data we are trying to store over there. Some CRMs are available. Some customer relationship management data we are storing. Some best of breed applications are available. My own customized applications are there. I may be prepared my own application. This is what we have. What is the need? I want to get some kind of business intelligence reports. I want to get some kind of corporate performance management. I want to get some kind of business process management, business activity monitoring. These are all things I want to do it. This is what currently what we have. This is what you needed. If I want to get like that, what we are trying to do, sir, we are using here data integration. We are trying to use it. This data integration may be contains. These are all steps we may be doing it. Migration, data warehousing, master data management, synchronization, federation, real-time messaging. A number of things are available. We'll try to understand those things later. Mainly, why I came to this window is, the last some slides are available. Those things I want to show it actually. Mainly, I came to this window to make you people to understand one point. See here, this was the format design. Here I have what, sir? Some CRM. Here I have what, sir? Some SCM, some legacy, some ERP, something is available. I am designing this one from where, sir? One table from here, like that I am taking and I am trying to design this overall mapping. That means you are trying to get the data from heterogeneous or not, sir? Can you write a SQL query, normal SQL query, to fetch the one column from one database, to get the one table, one column from another database, sir? Can you write SQL query? From SQL server, one table data I want, and from Oracle, one table data I want. These two things combinedly, can you write a single SQL query? No. There is no communication between basically SQL server and Oracle database. Because these two things are heterogeneous databases. Even though heterogeneous databases, I can take as an input for the my ODI. That's what you're trying to explain in this slide. Okay, right. So he's trying to generate the DDLs of something we are getting here. You see here this slide. We are taking all the tables from different things. We are trying to take it. Okay. So we are whatever you want, you can create it and you can see that one. Like this, it is happening. Okay, anyhow, this slide I will explain more clearly later point of time. You are not that mature to understand all the points here. Only one point what you need to understand is here, that is called as, what sir? Here, heterogeneous meaning is what? Heterogeneous means what sir? We have two different databases, then it is called as heterogeneous. The two different databases or a number of different databases I can take as input to the ODI and I can manipulate the data. That's what the one point what you need to understand. Then next one is available shared data between applications and systems. ODI's specialty is it is also going to support SOA, service oriented architecture. If you want to share the data from here to somewhere else to here, then you can share using the SOA integration. I can do that one. Right, that is the one point. Then projects that implement these integration requirements need to be delivered on spec. On spec means what? On time. On time means what? On budget means what? On spec means, let us say anyone is doing some project, they will have their own timelines or not, sir? And they will have their own budget. They will be saying as, okay, I am going to do, these are the activities, this is the activities I am going to do, this is what the time, this is what the money. Like that we are going to write one kind of spec. Spec is nothing but document. I am giving now one statement to you. I am going to complete our course within 30 to 35 days. That is what my statement. The statement is nothing but you can take a spec. Now, whatever I promised, in that way I need to deliver means what I should have, sir? I should have the one plan. I should have the predefined nodes. Predefined nodes is available means what, sir? That time will be reduced as whatever you need to write it. Yes or no? Directly I can give this printout, I can give to you. Same point, whatever I explained, same thing you need to write in the notes means it's going to take another 5 minutes or not. If I take a printout, if I give that will be very benefit to you. Right. Second is on time. If I given 3 months means yes, it's going to complete within 3 months only. Because we are not doing any R&D here. Already declared design is available. We are trying to simply enabling the options and we are doing it. On budget. Budget also, it is no hidden costs here. No hidden costs. Today I said like 100 hours it is going to take the work. It is going to take 100 hours only. If you take other tools and all, it may take 110 hours also. At the moment, extra 10 hours corresponding budget I need to allocate. That is the problem. So because of this ODA, we are getting here 3 benefits. On spec we can deliver, on time we can deliver, on budget you can deliver. These are the 3 major benefits whatever available. Next, a unique solution. In the market, this is what the unique, sir. Unique in the nature is, this kind of ELT architecture nowhere available. In the market, this is the only way it is going in one way. Remaining all tools are going in different way. That's what we are saying as a unique solution. First point in this one is Oracle Data Integrator employs a powerful declarative design approach to data integration which separates the declarative rules from the implementation details. Oracle Data Integrator is also based on a unique ELT architecture which eliminates the need for a standalone ETL server. Yesterday we understand the transformation is happening where, sir? The standalone ETL server in case of ETL. Here what, sir? Either on the target database side or on the source database side it is happening. Because of that one, we don't want dedicated ETL server here. Now, and appropriate engine and instead leverage the inherent power of RDBMS engine. We are going to use the RDBMS engine only we are using it. This combination provides the greatest productivity for both development and maintenance and the highest performance for the execution of data transformation and validation process. So that's what we're trying to justify. Next, here are the key reasons why companies choose Oracle Data Integrator for their integration needs. Why they are going for it, these are the key reasons. Number one, faster and simpler development and maintenance. Okay, the declarative rules driven approach to data integration greatly reduces the learning curve. What you need to learn, that will be very less time and very less topics also. Because of the less topics and less things, we can learn very quickly. Even I have, let us say, nowadays what is the main problem, sir? Did you notice that or not? Even our India also maturing nowadays, they are going for the contract employees in some cases. Why? Because when project is came, that project is, let us say, 3 months, we recruited one employee, thereafter we need to maintain that employee, means on the bench you cannot maintain it. That is the reason they will take as a contract, whenever the job is done, they will be removing that employee. Yes or no, sir? Right. So what I would like to say is here, you need not do like that. Let us say one Java resource is available in on bench, sir. One Java resource is available on bench. He has all the skill set. Yes or no, sir? Communication skills he has, document writing skills he has, mail writing skills he has, all skills he has. Only skill what is not there, sir, how to use ODA, you don't know. That's it. Yes or no? How much time it will take to train that guy, sir? Remaining all basic understanding he has. So ODA you need to learn means within a week of time I can make that guy as professional. Because he already mastered in one of the technologies, how system is behaving, that kind of things he knows it. Any one problem is came, how to search, where to search, how to resolve the problem, he knows minimal knowledge, yes or no? In initial days, let us say, whenever you are doing the degree or intermediate, at that moment you may not be knowing, let us say, I want to know some address, some theater address you don't know. Then what you are doing, sir? You are asking your friends. Yes or no, sir? Now you want means what you will do, sir? Immediately you will Google it. Similarly, one guy is worked on one technology for some years. If I given one more technology, only technology you don't know, the tool only you don't know. Remaining all process what, sir? He knows it. Communication skills is strong, documentation skills is strong, how the process is going to work out is strong. That reason, learning ODA is not going to take much time. If he is available on the bench, I can give one week of training and I can deploy into the ODA project. Because of that one, there is no process of terminate this employee and recruit one more employee. The terminating and recruiting both are very difficult tasks. Right. Next point, what I want to say is, learning curve is what, sir? Very decreases here of the product and increases developer productivity. As we have the learning curve is what, sir? Very less is available. With less, we can do more. That's what you mean to say. With less, what, sir? We can do more. Right. While facilitating ongoing maintenance, this approach separates the definition of the process from their actual implementation and separates the declared rules, the what from the data flows, the how. You are going to define what you want, that's it. How it has to flow, that will be taken care internally. You are defining, I want incremental loading, I want slowly changing dimension, I want full load. Like that, we are defining it. Remaining things are taken care by that one. Second one, data quality firewall. What is the one more practical issue is, we have this data sometime, but the quality is not there. Suppose you people are came, one interested guy is going to give your perfect contact number, perfect phone number, and perfect mail ID, those all things he'll give it. Just like that, if he came for the demo, then what will do, sir? You won't give your phone number properly. You won't give your mail ID properly. That is called as also some dirty data. That is called as some dirty data. That dirty data, I need to identify or not, sir? Minimum rules, some rules may be there. Let us say phone number must be 10 digits in nature. Okay, and mail ID should not have any spaces. Mail ID should be ending with @of. Some kind of rules may be there. Those all rules you need to define it. You can define those all rules in the data quality firewall. ODA has one strong data quality firewall is available. I would like to open the tool also parallelly. Where is the tool C? Yeah, tool C I want to open. This is what the tool I am trying to open, ODA tool C. B106 batch, supervisor, okay. It's connecting to the repository. Right. If you go and see here, let us say I am going to the tables. This is what the tables are available. on this table I want to implement here some kind of rules. Then I can go here and I can define what's here, whatever rule I want I can define it. Okay, right click on this one, new condition, whatever condition you want you can keep it. This condition is going to accept all the things whatever you wanted. That means you can write one SQL query here, or you can use whatever you want, database condition it may be, or Oracle data integration condition it may be. Okay, you have your control also defined in the database. You want to use directly, you can use it. It is static or it may be flow, whatever you want you can use it. Okay, we'll learn more about that one later point of time. I have one thing that is called as a constraints inside the ODI level. And here this constraints also a number of constraints is going to support it. For this they have one specialized KM is available that is known as what sir? CKM, check knowledge module, check knowledge module. Fine, that's what he's trying to say in the second point. The second point, data quality firewall is available, data quality firewall is available. First point is what sir? Faster and simpler development and maintenance. Second is what sir? Data quality firewall. Third one, better execution performance, better execution performance. Traditional data integration software ETL is based on appropriate engine that perform data transformation row by row, thus limiting what sir? Performance. By implementing ELT architecture based on your existing RDBMS engines and SQL, you are capable of executing data transformation on the target server. It is set based level. Set means what sir? A group of records. Based level giving you much higher performance. Here it has to process one by one row. What is the process happening, sir? From database to ETL server, the data has to move first. While it is moving, how it can move, sir? One by one record is going to move it. But this is doing the transformation where, sir? Directly in the database only it is doing. That is the reason a set of records is going to do at a time. Clear? Because of that one, we are saying as better execution performance. The better execution performance we are achieving by using one concept, what sir? Normally all the traditional tools are following the row by row approach. This is following what? Set based approach, a group of records approach. Right, let us move on to the next one that is called as simpler and more efficient architecture. Simpler and more efficient architecture. If you go and see the architecture, already people are aware of it. It contains ELT architecture, remaining all things are ETL. Because of this one, we can do the complex things very easily. We can do it. Then platform independent. This is excellent thing. Normally, if you observe or not, if I want to install the Informatica on Unix machine, then while you're downloading itself, what you are going to do, sir? You need to download the Unix corresponding Informatica. Or you want to install on the 32-bit software, 32-bit of the Windows, you want to install it. You need to download the software is what, sir? 32-bit software or not? If you want to install the 64-bit, you want to install it, then you need to download 64-bit only. That means they designed the softwares, okay, you see 32-bit, then one software. You see 64-bit, then one software. You see Unix, then one software. Different softwares are available for different operating systems. This is platform independence. You will give only one setup file. That's it. This setup file, you can install in the Unix or Linux or Windows-based 32-bit system or 64-bit system. It is a platform independent. That is one of the greatness whatever available here. Right. So, that point is very clear. Oracle Data Integrator supports many platforms, hardwares and operating systems with the same software. We need not go for the different softwares. Right. That is the reason if you go and observe, let us say I am going to the ODI software download. Then Oracle site is came here. If you go and see the Oracle site, I have here the latest version is what, sir? Oracle Data Integration, Toll CR1, Toll Point 1.2.00. That's what we are working actually. And previous to this one is what, sir? 11.1.1.7. That also we are going to work. If you go and expand this all platforms here, whatever available. Do I have here something Windows 32-bit something, 64-bit something like that? Only one setup is available or all different things are there, sir? Only one is available. If you click on this, this means it is going to give your username and password is going to ask. If you provide your username and password, single sign-on, it is going. If you provide your username and password, then that's it. We are going to download it. Am I clear? Right. Now, that point is clear. Suppose if I go for other softwares, let us say Google, then I want to go for, let us say, OVAW software. I want to go, sir, OVAW software download. In case of OVAW software, if you go and see, what is available here? Oracle Business Intelligence 11.1.1.6. If I click on this all supported platforms, then what is saying, sir? Yours is a 32-bit system, then download this one. Yours is a 64-bit system, then download this one. Yours is a Linux 32-bit, then use it. Linux 64-bit, then use it. That means what, sir? For each operating system, they have separate setup files are available. But in case of ODI, what, sir? One guy. One guy going to do all the activities, whatever you needed. All the platforms, it is going to support using the single software. That's what meaning of platform independence. Next one is data connectivity. There is no limitation, sir. It can connect to n number of databases. You can go and you can see here what are the databases it is going to connect. These are the databases. What you give some names, those all names you can identify here. Even we have here Hive. Hive is nothing but Hive HBase. These things are Hadoop corresponding things. These things are what, sir? Hadoop corresponding things. That Hadoop corresponding things also we are supporting it. Whatever Hadoop database is available, the HDFS file system, this is HBase stands for Hadoop database. HBase stands for Hadoop database. From the Hadoop first letter you take N, from the database last base you take N and given as HBase. Okay, right. Similarly, Hive also, this also Hadoop corresponding thing only. Now, you can go and you can see your known databases, MySQL, your known database, next word, sir, Oracle, your known database. Next word, sir, Microsoft Office Excel, Microsoft SQL Server. You may be aware of it, SAP, Teradata, Timestamp, Sybase. These all things are you are aware of it. So almost all the databases we are supporting or not? We are supporting all the databases. That's what the meaning of data connectivity. It is going to connect all the databases what you are looking for. Then cost saving. The elimination of the ETL server we are eliminating totally. That means ETL engine reduces both the initial hardware. If I want to run the ETL server, means I require separate CPU, separate RAM, separate hard disk. These all things are not, sir. Yes. Now on software acquisition and maintenance cost. You need to purchase the software and you need to purchase the licenses and every year you need to pay this much of license amount to the customer. These all headaches are reduced here. The reduced learning curve and increased developer productivity significantly reduce the overall labor cost. Labor cost also very important. Same work using Informatica, I am taking 10 hours. Same work in Informatica, I am using 10 hours. Let us say, here I am using what, sir? Only 1 hour I am using. So, automatic labor cost is decreasing or not? Yes. Now, ongoing maintenance also is going to decrease. Yes. Next point, ODI installation. Now, anyone ask in the interview the question, tell me some of the benefits of ODI. Some of the benefits of ODI. What my expectation from you is, whatever I highlighted, right, headings, faster and simpler development and maintenance, data quality firewall, better execution performance, simpler and more efficient, platform independence, data connectivity, cost savings. At least the 7 points you try to tell it. Out of the 7, if you are able to remember 5, that is well and good. Why ODI? Why ODI? What are the benefits of ODI? How it is different from other tools? Then you can tell these all 7 points so that we are able to answer the question how it is different from other tools and why ODI? What are the benefits of ODI? These all questions answer is set. Right. Let us move on to the next one that is called as ODI installation. ODI installation. ODI installation is the simplest installation, sir. Simplest installation. I hope everyone aware of it, how to install the database first, right? Yes or no, sir? Oracle database or SQL Server database, how to install, you know it, right? Nothing, sir. If you don't know also, just put your setup file, click on next, that's it. Close your eyes, click on next. That is what the Oracle database installation means. Prerequisite for the ODI installation is, you should have any one database. You should have any one data, because tomorrow we are going to work with the database only, right? So we should have any one database. That is a free request. Second one, second free request is we should have the JDK file, Java. Java JDK is required because the software is going to run backend using the JDK. The JDK versions, is, if you go and see on my screenshot, I used the JDK version. What is the version? 1.6 version I used it. But I recommend you people to go for whatever latest is available. Even though the screenshot I captured long ago, that is the reason we have 1.6. But present I am using, JDK. What is the version? 1.7. Just you can download JDK very simply. You can download from the Google only. Let us say go to the Google. Then you can say JDK. Then immediately we are getting what's the latest version is? 7 is the latest version. Download. Then automatically you are going to get for what operating system. You can select corresponding operating system and you can download it. Okay. Now we have present version is JDK 1.7. So try to use that one. Am I clear? And the software corresponding to Oracle version, corresponding software version is, if you go and see Oracle 11 point, what is it, sir? 2.0.3 and 2.0.4, two things are available. In the publicly, it is not available, sir, actually 2.0.3 and 2.0.4. But we have that one, We need to download from the service portal. We need to download. We download it and we have that one. Publicly meaning is Oracle, let us say 11z download if I am writing here. Then if you go and see the Oracle website, then you can see here two version only we are seeing it. Accept the license. Here what is the version, sir? 12c. Below that one we have what? 11.2.0.2.0 only. But what is not there, sir? 3.0. 4.0 not available. That's what I am trying to tell. Okay, but we have that softwares are available. I think I captured in my system also. Let me see it. If available, I will show it. Softwares. Yeah, this is what the Oracle 11.2.0.3. I recommend anyhow we are doing the new installation only we are doing, right? I recommend the version is 11.2.0.3 version I am recommending. Okay, right. Then if possible, take the 0.4 also. After this, one more version is there. That is called as 0.4, 11.2.0.4. Okay, 12c is not required for time being. Oracle 12c is not required. Don't go for the Oracle 12c. Go with the Oracle 11g only. In that one, 0.3 and 0.4 versions you need to go. Am I clear? Right. And second request is what? JDK. JDK is what is the version? 7th version, JDK 7th version. Please write these 2 points somewhere. The free requests. Install what, sir? Oracle. What is the version? 11.2.0.3 or 4. Okay. And JDK 6th or 7th, but recommended is what, sir? 7th is the recommended. I am writing directly 7. I am writing here. 7 is the recommended, so I am writing directly 7. I am writing. Okay, right. Now, if people understand that point very clearly. Okay, let us move on to the next one. Once you have these two things are available, Oracle installation is completed, JDK installation is completed. Okay, next is we need to go for your ODA download. ODA from where you can download it. ODA software from where you can download it. You can download ODA software directly from the net. You can download, sir. Here itself, previously I typed it, right? ODA software download, you are going to get it. But for you people, I don't think so it is required to download. We have already all the things are available. You can take the pen drive and you can copy it and you can go for it. ODA 11G as well as ODA, 12C, both the things are available. Even the softwares, OBA software and JDK, whatever I am saying, these all things are available here. You can take this one. Minimum size of the your pen drive is 4 GB is required. These all softwares will be holding over there. Now, next, once we have everything, we download the software also, then what we need to do is we need to open the command prompt. How to open command prompt, sir? Here we need to go for CMD. This command prompt is open. Then we need to point out to the location wherever Java is available. How to point out, sir? CD. CD stands for change your directory. Change your directory. Where is our Java is available? Suppose here it is available. Then go to the directory, control C. Then try to provide that one. Click on what, sir? Edit. Then paste it. Like this, you can change the path. Now, similar like change the path. Then what is the syntax, sir, here? You need to write here java-jar. Then we have your ODA. Once you download it, we'll get one kind of file that is called as .jar file. We'll get it. Give that path where it is available. In my mission, let us say it is available in the E drive. In the softwares, it is available. If it is available in the E drive, in the softwares, it is available means I am going to give this location only. I am going to give here. Suppose if it is available here. Okay, it is not there with me actually. Okay. Then once you provide that path, automatically it is going to take care of, it is going to take care of extracting and we will get this kind of window we are going to get it. Only some kind of care you need to take only in the first step, sir. If the first step is completed, remaining steps automatically will complete. Only care what, sir? We need to provide this proper Java location. Observe the screenshot once you come to understand how to do it. Then -jar and path of the file where it is available, the setup file. This is the only one step, you need to be a bit careful. Remaining things are very simple, all are user friendly. This is about the window, what you are going to get it. Thereafter, we are going to get this a welcome screen. How many steps process, sir, it is? It is a 7 steps process. First step is nothing. We are going to install what type of software it is going to give, the version and everything it is going to give to you. And what is the second step? The second step is contents. The second step is going to be where you are installing that one. The location. By default, it is going to take into the C drive, Oracle, middleware. If you want to give some other location, we can provide it. In my case, I didn't change it to the path. That is the reason the C drive, in the Oracle, in the middleware, only we have the 12C is installed, ODA is installed here. Okay, that's what here available. Next one. This is what the second step. We are providing here where you want to install the location. Third step is available. What you are going to install? We have two types of installations. One is standalone. Second is enterprise installation. Standalone and the second is enterprise installation. Standalone means we won't get much components, sir. Much components we are not going to get it. That is the reason we are going to prefer you to enterprise installation. This is the one point what you need to remember. While you're doing what, sir, you need to change the radio button from standalone installation to enterprise installation. You need to change it. That is the one step. Then once you did it, then you need to go for next one. Automatically, it is going for the next one. It is checking what, sir? Checking operating system certification. Checking service pack, whatever available. Checking physical memory. Checking Java version used to launch the installer. If you given Java version something wrongly, 6th version or 5th version, something you given it. 6th version is okay. 5th version or something you given it, automatically it is going to throw error here. If your operating system is not supporting, then also it is going to throw error. Sir, what operating systems is going to support then? I recommend you to go for Windows XP or Windows 7. If you are going for the server versions, Windows 2003 or Windows 2008 or Windows 2012, whatever you want, you can go for it. And I recommend the service pack 1 is available in my mission, but I recommend the service pack 2 is available, get that one. Even in our front office also, we have that one. I recommend is what, sir? Server 2003 service pack 2. First priority, what I will give, if you ask me the priority means, I can give the server versions, I can give the priority. Because Windows 7, Windows XP not recommended to install the softwares. In our life, anyone is installing the softwares in Windows 7 or Windows XP, sir? No. You may be using Macs as a client versions, not the server installation purpose. That's the reason I too recommend to go with the server 2003 or server 2008, I'll recommend it. I'll recommend it. And one more point. If you are using Windows 8, you are using Windows 8, you are using ODI is going to install in Windows 8 also. But Windows 8 means I think your laptop is new laptop only, right? Yes or no, sir? Your laptop is new laptop only. You may have the RAM size of 6 GB or 8 GB of the RAMs. If you have the 6 or 8 GB of the RAMs, then I recommend to go with VMware. One concept is available. What is that? VMware one concept is available. Go and try to install the VMware. Inside the VMware, try to install the server or something. Okay, how to install that one process, everything is available with the admin. We can contact the admin to install the things. Readily VMware is available. Am I clear? Right. So you people understand what are the operating systems you require. Then let us move on to the next one. That is called as step 5 of 7. It is going to give the summary window. What exactly it is going to install it. Then step 6 of 7. Again, it's trying to prepare it, copy it, generating the libraries. These all things is doing one by one activity. This is what the somewhat time taking process. Remaining all steps are what the next are clicking. In this window, it may be waiting for some time. It is going to wait because it has to do this one by one task. Once these all things are completed, that's it. We completed step 7 of 7. Installation is completed. It is going to give you the summary window what it is done. Then click on finish button. Are you observing any difficulty here, sir? Any difficulties there here? No, right? Just we have the 7 steps are available. We are doing the next we are doing. Very easy. Only thing what you need to take care is, before this you need to install the Oracle software and what, sir? JDK. Those things you need to install the proper versions. And operating system also proper version. I recommend Windows, whatever I said, right? Those things. Suppose you are trying to install Windows Server 2003 without service packs. It is going to throw the error. Even you are using service pack 1 also, it is going to throw the warning. You can ignore that warning and can move forward. As for the Oracle guy, it is recommended is service pack 2. Service pack 2 is recommended one. You are getting my point? Okay. Now, if people understand how to install the product, and second one is we understand today what's the introduction about the ODI. So today we understand two things. One is ODI benefits or ODI introduction. Second is what, sir? ODI installation process. By tomorrow, what is my expectation is you should be ready with installation process. And whatever material I am referring here, that material printout should be there in your hand. So that you can follow my notes very clearly. Suppose any one point extra I am telling, let us say, today I given one extra point. What is the point, sir? This is the point what I given extra. This one you written somewhere separate book, then it is a integration is a problem. Yes or no? We are working with the integration tool. You should be available all the matter in the integration one document. So try to write the same thing on the screenshot or somewhere. So that all the information will be at one place. Okay, this document should be with you people. And chapter wise PowerPoints also available. Those things you need to download from my Google Drive. They will give you the guidelines how to download it. And third one, installation should be complete by tomorrow. These are the three things what should be happen. And ODI 11G installation also similar to this one, sir. I don't have the documentation here. If you want really, then you can go and you can see in the Google also, you can see it. ODI 11G installation. Same steps will be there, sir. You need not worry about it. Installation steps I am going. Then if you go and see, no screenshots. See, this is what the, again, what's that? Command prompt window. This is 11G window. Then same steps are available or not? Almost all same steps will be available. You need not worry about it. Okay, if you want, I can share this link also to online folks. If you want to install the 11G also, you can do it. And if you face the problem in installation, need not worry, my admin is available, my admin is going to connect to your PCs and he is going to do that one. For all online folks, he is going to connect to your PC and he is going to do it. Temporarily, you can use my remote server also, you can use it. Am I clear? Right. Thank you. Tomorrow we'll discuss remaining things. Any questions? Any questions? Yes, sir. Any question? What is your good name? Bengal Reddy. Gangadhar. Okay. Any questions, Gangadhar? No? Okay. That's good. Okay, sir. Thank you. Bye-bye. Tomorrow we'll meet.